Hello, Apple Valley High School Fab Lab students. It's Mr. Lee, and today what we're going to do is look at how to engrave onto a pint glass. And so what I've got here are a couple examples, and I wanted to have a dark background to show you this, but we actually engraved on this glass, and here's another one that we engraved on one side and then we engraved on the other side. We were doing this to just test to see how the image looked. So the pint glasses that we're gonna use look like this. And what we need to know about this is the circumference. So I'm gonna use this digital caliper to measure the circumference. I'll zero it out. We're gonna measure in inches. And you notice that the top of it is about 3.5 inches, just under. The bottom of it is about 2.5, and the middle is right around 3. So we're gonna use that middle diameter for our calculations. And the circumference is pi times the diameter. So pi is 3.14, and our diameter is 3 inches, so we have about 9 inches to engrave if we wanted to engrave all the way around. On the top part, it wouldn't go quite all the way around, and then on the bottom, it would go more than the full circumference. So what we tend to do is we tend to engrave on about a third of the glass. So if I look at the width of this, it's about 3 inches. And if I look at the height on this one, it's about 3.6 inches. On this glass, it's about a little over 3 inches. So that's about the maximum size of the image that you're gonna wanna design. So when you're looking for images, they should be a black and white image. And they should, you can have them pretty detailed, but the more simple, the better. So that's what we're gonna kinda look at. So the next part of this video, I'm gonna open up Adobe Illustrator, and then we'll prep the file for printing, and then we'll bring it over to the laser, and I'll show you how that's set up, and then we'll print one. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna use Adobe Illustrator to create the image that we're gonna put on the pint glass. So I'm gonna go down to my taskbar. I've already opened up Adobe Illustrator 2020. And what I want to do is create a new file. So I could go up to File and then New, or I could just say Create New. And I have this preset already in here because I use this size for my workspace. So it's 10 inches wide by 10 inches in height. So I'm going to hit Create. It's RGB, which is fine. The laser, we're not gonna be cutting, we're just gonna be engraving. So I'm gonna hit Create. I've already looked up an image, and the image is the Apple Valley Eagle. So I'm gonna go to File and Place, and I'm gonna place that image into my workspace, and it's pretty big. So I'm going to resize it to fit once I image trace it. So I'm going to go up to this menu at the top. And if I hit the down arrow, you get different ways to image trace it, but I just am going to do the default. So the default just image traces the black and white, and then I'm going to expand that. And I don't need this any of this white anymore, so I'm gonna right click on this, and then I'm gonna isolate it, and then I'm gonna select just that white part that I don't want, and I'll hit the backspace key or the delete key to get rid of that. So now I have my image. I'm gonna double click to get out of isolation mode. You see I opened up layers, and I'm in my isolation mode for that. So I'll double click out of that. You notice that it changed. So this is all the stuff that the image tracing did to bring the JPEG image into this file. I am gonna turn on my rulers. So that's the Control key and the R key. And then I'm going to also turn on the grid just for reference. So that's the control key and then the quote key. So we could print this right now the way it is. If you go to Window and open up your Transform button, like I have, and then select All or Control and then the A key, you can see that our width is 11 inches and the height 7, so that's actually bigger than the glass that we have. So I'm going to make this only about 3.5 inches tall. So the height I'm going to change to 3.5. You notice that the chain is linked together, so whatever I do to one box, height or width affects the other. So I'm going to make that 3.5, hit the tab key, and it automatically adjusts the width. So my width is about 5 inches. That's pretty good. I think I'm going to change it, the height, to about 3 inches. And that looks like that'll be better. It can center it on the glass pretty well. So the other issue we have to deal with is that this image has to be rotated. And in our laser that we're using, we need to rotate it 90 degrees. So if I type in a 90 into the transform window, if I typed in 90, it would rotate it clockwise. So then it would be upside down. So I'm going to do that just to show you. And grab it and bring it back into view. So that would look upside down on the glass. So I'm going to undo that. And I actually need to rotate it the other direction. So I'll go back to the way it was originally. I can also rotate about these different points. You notice I've been rotating it above the left corner of the paper. I'm going to do it about the center, and then it'll stay in the frame. So if we type in a minus 90, so negative key and then 90, that'll rotate it clockwise. And really, essentially, I'm done. I'm ready to print because it's black and white. Anything that looks black in the image will have a frosted look on the glass. And then anything that's white will not get engraved at all, so it'll be clear. So that one's ready to go. I'm going to save that as an Illustrator file. So I'll do save. And I'm going to do same thing, Lee, C, and this is for my second hour A cohort class. And I'm going to call this just glass, because we're engraving on the glass. Save it as an Illustrator file to my desktop, and then I'm going to pull that into my computer that runs the machine, and we'll look at that next.